Chancellor of Aligarh, Professor Tariq Mansoor, is not around, so I will take the liberty of inviting our next speaker. So it's an honor and privilege for me to invite Professor Talat Ahmed, Vice Chancellor of University of Kashmir, to present his talk. But before I do so, please give me a couple of minutes to introduce him. Professor Talat Ahmed completed his bachelor's and master's degree in geology from Aligarh Muslim University in 1977. And went on to complete his PhD from JNU in 1985. Between 1988 and 2000, he worked as a postdoctoral fellow at the University of Leicester, UK, the University of Cambridge in UK, and Nagoya University in Japan. He worked as a scientist at the Wadia Institute of Himalayan Geology in Dehradun from 1983 to 2003. And after that, he joined Delhi University as a professor of geology. I feel proud to say that Professor Talat is one of the finest geologists in the country has ever produced, and he holds the rare distinction of being a member of all the three science academies of the country, namely the Fellow of the Indian National Science Academy, the Fellow of Indian Academy of Sciences, and the National Academy of Sciences, besides being a J.C. Bose National Fellow, which was conferred to him by the Department of Science and Technology, New Delhi. He also received the National Mineral Award in 1994 from the Ministry of Steel and Mines, and the SM Naqvi Gold Medal in 2013 from the Geological Society of India. He took over the charge of Vice Chancellor of University of Kashmir in 2011, and he stayed there till May 2014. And then he went on to become the VC of Jamia Millia Islamia, where he served from May 2014 to August 2018. Then he again joined the University of Kashmir as the Vice Chancellor for his second term. He joined in August 2018, and currently he is the Vice Chancellor of University of Jammu and Kashmir. His notable achievements as Vice Chancellor Kashmir University are the NAAC accreditation grade A, and apart from that, he created satellite campuses in Leh, Kargil, and Kupwara to bring higher education to these geographically isolated and underdeveloped regions, dominated by scheduled tribes and other backward classes. He set up an extensive recruitment and placement initiative for the youth of Jammu and Kashmir, which was undertaken by the Kashmir University under the Udaan program of the Government of India. And his contributions at Jamia Millia Islamia include the NAAC accreditation grade A, and he's also been credited with the creation of the new positions of Dean of Research and Dean of Academics, besides opening up a number of new courses in the university. Professor Ahmed, as I told you in the beginning, he is one of the finest geologists the country has produced. He has to his credit 110 research publications in national and international scientific journals of repute. He has five edited journal volumes, and he has supervised 23 PhD theses. With these few words, I'd like to hand over this virtual stage to Professor Talat Ahmed, Vice Chancellor of University of Kashmir.
Thank you very much, and Assalamu Alaikum, all my colleagues and my friends, His Excellency Dr. Asaf Saeed Sahab, Lieutenant General Zameer Uddin Shah Sahab, Madam Najma Akhtar Sahiba, Vice Chancellor, Jamia Millia, Professor Faisan Mustafa Sahab, Vice Chancellor, Nalsar, Professor Jafri, Vice Chancellor, Hamdard University, Sufyan Beg Sahab, Chairman AMU Alumni Association, Engineer Hashmi Sahab, my other colleagues and all the colleagues, welcome and Assalamu Alaikum. It's a pleasure to be part of this very important occasion. During this COVID period, we could not really visit Aligarh, but our heart is always in Aligarh, as I have spent nearly 5 years as student in Aligarh, and still the good memories of Aligarh is there, and it will always remain. Actually, Aligarh is a place, and because of Sir Sayyad, obviously, that we are all now in a position, as Zameer Uddin Shah Sahab told about the contributions of this Aligarh movement, which was started by Sir Sayyad, and the situation of the Muslims that time around 1857 and onwards was very, very bad, because we were treated as the real culprit to for this war, or making problems for the Britishers. And Sir Sayyid did realize that although there were Muslim rulers before the British, and they had the language of Persian as the language of knowledge, but with time it was diminishing. And the best course was that what Sir Sayyid taught us was to learn the modern science and modern education through English, which was very important. And he dreamt of Cambridge and Oxford in India in particular, which was a dream which was very difficult at that time, when the Orthodox, particularly the Orthodox Muslims, were very much against all this new ideas. And Sir Sayyid had really very difficult task to start this Anglo MAO, Mohammedan Anglo Oriental College, in 1875. And then he started also, to start with, he says that we have to have science, maths, philosophy, and modern thoughts in such a way that to start with, when we don't have command on English, he started a movement of translating the English literature, English material, English knowledge into Urdu, so that people can get educated. See, the thing is, you may get knowledge, it is very, very important in any language, but it is always easier to learn, in your own language, it's much easier to grasp. But at the same time, given the situation, even for now you understand that really Sir Sayyid was visionary. That time itself, he said that English is important and one has to learn. Now we know that we have big advantage in the world that by knowing English and speaking in English, and very easy to communicate from the world over. Okay, so he started this movement in Muradabad. He started a school, and then Ghazipur, he started another school to start with. And then he was really visionary, I would say, is that he started something known as Mohammedan Civil Service Funds Association. He was of the opinion that you cannot just do something and survive. You have to get into the system. And he got some of these funds collected together to send to some of the bright Muslims to go to London and take IECS exams. Even that time, you can imagine that he had this vision. So now we know, everybody, all of us are trying to have more and more representation in services, in the government, okay, in the forces, and everywhere, because until unless the community is educated and it takes part in the mainstream, you are going to be lost. And I think that the lesson that we got from Sir Sayyid that time, we have to just follow, and we should be just a small soldier and act like a soldier for Sir Sayyid. Wherever we are, we should try to educate our people, because until unless you have education in the society, your country or your community is not going to progress. Okay, they may do business, they can get into politics, but that can be lost with time. But if you are educated, you are going to be always there, and you are going to make a mark. We know that there are lots of alumni, very, very famous people, and to be very, very proud about it, is that during the freedom struggle, 46 people, very, very important people, were the freedom fighters for our country. It has produced four head of the states in India, in Pakistan, Bangladesh, and Maldives. Similarly, we have produced also Supreme Court and High Court judges in seven countries, passing out from Aligarh, in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Uganda, Tanzania, Nigeria, and also in England, Great Britain. We have produced also two Bharat Ratna in the form of Khan Abdul Ghaffar Khan Saab and Dr. Zakir Hussain Saab. So these are some of the very, very important contributions of Aligarh. And then when we are celebrating this 100 years, we should remember these people. I would also like to emphasize that Aligarh was built and Sir Syed did a lot to get funds and start this MAO college. And the contributors were not only Muslims. There were people who were Britishers. Okay, the Viceroy has contributed, and also Raja Mahendra Singh of Patiala, Raja Shambhu Narayan from Banaras, and obviously Nizam of Hyderabad, Mir Usman Ali Saab. So there were people from all walks of life who contributed to the formation of Aligarh, and then we all got benefited. We have stayed in Aligarh. I can still remember the advantages being in the hostel. This is one of the university, in addition to maybe Jamia Millia and Vishwa Bharati, where you start from school, primary school, and go up to PhD and even postdoc level. Okay, and then obviously we always remember the Tarana of Aligarh and the hostel tradition. See, it is not only that you get educated. Aligarh was also a place where you learned culture of the country, the richness. Okay, there was something called introduction. Many of you still remember. Okay, now it is banned as ragging, but that time introduction was something jise kehte hain ki aap apni jhijak jo bacche aate hain chote shahar se ya gaon se ya even kahin se bhi. So these are some of the things which help you build the personality. And always there were people with very open heart to help you, whether it was the hostel bearer or your provost or warden or your seniors. Okay, so that always we have to remember. Aligarh has also produced lots of sports people. One of my contemporary, I can just say about Zafar Iqbal, excellent person, still he is around. And when I was in Jamia, he was a very frequent visitor. Okay, so we are present all over the world. It's very important contribution of Aligarh. Very few universities will have this sort of alumni association all over and so active. So I am very, very sure that this type of activity that this Riyadh chapter is doing is going to have lots of impact and lots of importance. Some of the things, as you know, I come from research background, so I would emphasize that university has to run, it has to do lots of research in addition to good teaching, good research. Research should be such that people all over the world know you and know your university because of your work. All right. And now the most burning topic, being a earth science person, will be climate change. How much we understand the climate change? Just now Shah Saab was telling. तो इस दफा जो है वो सबसे ज्यादा सर्दी पड़ने वाली है 70 सालों में. बट इफ यू सी एज अ साइंटिस्ट, दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी लॉन्ग टर्म थिंग, ओके, व्हिच गोज एंड कम्स. बट दीज आर स्मॉल स्पर्ट्स ऑफ बीइंग वेरी हॉट ईयर और वेरी कोल्ड ईयर. बट हाउ मच डू वी अंडरस्टैंड इफ वी डू रिसर्च इन दीज एंगल्स, पर्टिकुलरली बीइंग इन द हिमालयस. ओके, दीज आर गोइंग टू बी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सिमिलरली I was very happy to learn from Shah Sahab, but obviously I was knowing also some people in Aligarh that they have been working on the water resources. Okay, artificial intelligence is another area which needs to be understood. And most importantly, for any university, and this I take this liberty to tell to all my vice chancellor's colleagues, don't treat a university some sort of just keeping people under your control. Let them have full freedom of thought. Full freedom of thought is very important, because academics are not going to be run by having some sort of steel arm or some such thing, or the policing. But let people have total freedom in terms of thinking, in terms of research, in terms of expression. Meet people, meet the students, meet their teachers, understand their problems. They will be the right things to do, which is going to make the university. I remember first time when I joined in Kashmir, there was no accreditation of NAC. I did that, did hard work, we got A grade. I went to Jamia, I thought that Jamia is very old, so definitely, I was surprised that even Jamia was not NAC accredited, okay? The university was at 84th position. When I was leaving, it became 12th. So you have to give freedom, you have brain, you have very intelligent people, but let them work with free hand. MashaAllah, when I have come back to Kashmir, I was very happy that we could get this university now as A+. So all these things, we have bright minds, we have intelligence. Only thing is, there has to be total freedom in terms of research, thinking, and expression. So I wish all the Aligarhs the very, very best for the centenary year. And I look forward, whatever little I can do for the university and for my Aligarh and my friends from Aligarh and the Aligarhians, I will be happy to do. Thank you so much, and God bless Aligarh. Khuda hafiz.